Good morning, dear student. Hope everything is well and all are having the good health. I think all are missing the college days, canteen, hostel, mess, NASA point. Due to the current scenario and pandemic situation, your education is disturbed. But unlike any time in the past, we have the ability to continue education even college closed. We have to accept the fact and try to overcome. Learners, teachers and families are at the heart of everything person does, and we are the committed to helping everyone have positive learning experience, whether online or offline. In this uncertain environment, it's important that learning continues. Civil Engineering Department of Dr. Vitthal Rao Vikhe Patil College of Engineering, Ahmednagar, providing online teaching learning process through Google Classroom, Google Meet, Sampark app, etc. Dear student, we'll start with the introduction to syllabus. Before start, you must be aware about the myself, Dr. M.P. Wagh, working as associate professor in Civil Engineering Department since 2002. Department vision. So department having the vision to impart the quality technical education for competent civil engineers to meet the need of society, and to complete the vision, department having the mission to develop a civil engineer graduates for planning, design and education of economy based eco-friendly projects for sustainable development, to inspire the student and inculcate a sense of competitiveness for higher studies, research and entrepreneurship in field of civil engineering, to ingrain in students professionalism towards the engineering having ethical, social and the human values, to model civil engineer to work as a global leaders for development of the society. Now introduction to syllabus. Everyone aware about that from 2020-21 your syllabus is changed, and you are having the in first semester subject building technology and architecture planning. This subject is purposefully added in a syllabus because you must be aware about the architecture planning, how to plan a building in innovative manner, how to construct the building. Now introduction to teaching learning process. Teaching scheme having the 3 hours per week, practical 4 hours per week, examination scheme in SEM 30 marks, end SEM 70 marks, term work 50 marks, credit. This subject having the 3 credits for theory and 2 credits for practical. Now university structure. As per the Pune University, building technology and architecture planning, mechanics of structure, fluid mechanics, engineering mathematics 3, engineering geology. The total 700 marks for this 5 subject plus term work practical and tutorials. Credit, theory having the 15 credits, practical having the 6 credit, tutorial having 1 credit, and total 22 credits. Now objective of this subject is to learn about the different types of structural requirement, to describe all the basic activities of construction, to study the different types of material and building bylaws, to plan a different building units, town planning parameters and safety of building. And last objective is our architectural aspect used in construction for civil engineering student. Now course outcome, after studying this subject, you can get the knowledge about different points. First point is you can identify the types of building, their requirement and the components of building. You aware about the architecture principles and building bylaws for building construction. You can effectively plan residential building. You can effectively plan public buildings such as bank, office, school, etc. You can easily implemented principles of building bylaws for town planning. You can implement the concept of three magnet also. And last outcome is you can understand the various services and safety aspects. Safety aspect is very important for construction point of view, for civil engineering point of view. Now detail about the subject, detail introduction. So unit first is introduction to building construction and masonry, which requires the 6 hours. So first part is introduction to building construction. Second part is masonry and third part is formwork. I'm not going in detail about the syllabus because already displayed. I will put the soft copy also so you can get the knowledge about the unit one. Unit two consists of the building bylaws, necessity of building bylaws, built up area, carpet area, rules for ventilation, lighting, vertical circulation, sanitation, parking of vehicle, etc. And second part is introduction to architectural drawing, which includes the different building bylaws, such as aspect, prospect, luminaire, grouping, sanitation, elegance, economy, etc. Third unit is building components, which consist of the different components such as doors, windows. Then it consists of the B part is arch and lintel, function requirement of flooring, then roofing material. Unit number 4 consists of the residential building, function requirement and the dimension of residential building like bungalow, twin bungalow, etc. Green building, salient feature of green building, concept of green building, which included in unit number 4. Unit number 5 is planning of public building, which consists of the functional requirement and dimension of planning of a public building like hostel, college, auditorium hall, restaurant, hospital, etc. So you have to plan all these public buildings properly and how to draw and how to develop a plan, that you have to study unit number 5. Unit number 6 is town planning and legal aspect, which include the Satbara, abstract, form number 6, TDR, safety aspect and services, noise, ventilation, necessity of ventilation, lighting, plumbing. All these are included in unit number 6. Now reference books for this subject. So building material by S.K. Duggal, building construction by Rangwala, the construction of building by the 7th edition volume 1 volume 2 is available, building material and technology by Bentley. These are some reference books. Textbook, building construction by B.C. Punia, building material by the S.V. Devdhar, building construction by Bindrayan Arora. So these are some textbooks which are essential for this subject. Now we start about the lecture. So topic of today's lecture is building components and their requirement, foundation, purpose of foundation, substructure, superstructure, sill level and lintel level. Now this is a picture which gives the basic idea about the components of building. So building having the different components, foundation, plinth level, staircase, ground floor, windows, doors, pillar, first floor, wall, roof, ceiling, etc. So these are the basic components of building. Then building components are divided into the different parts. A part consists of the wall finish, floor finish, ceiling work, staircase, etc. Structural part, that is the B part, consists of the retaining wall, footing, beam, column, slab, staircase, reinforcement, etc. Mechanical part is the third one, which consists of the heating, ventilation, air conditioning, lift system, etc. Group D is electrical work. Electrical work is electrical system, telephones, data cables, electric supply, etc. Plumbing work, that is water supply and distribution system, sanitary work, disposal system, etc. Now building components, so building having the two basic component, one is called as a substructure, another is called as a superstructure. The structure below the earth surface is called as substructure and structure above the ground level is called as the superstructure. So superstructure consists of first floor, second floor, roof, beam, column, which are included, doors, window, which are included in superstructure, and substructure, which consists of the foundation and footings. Now, from this diagram, you can get the knowledge about the different components of building. You can guess what are the components you are observing in this diagram. At the end, I will ask the question on this point. Now, building, what is the meaning by the building? So, building is nothing but the human habitation, which include the foundation, plinth, wall, floors, roofs, chimney, plumbing system, building services, fixed platform, veranda, balcony, etc. So this is the diagram is shown. That diagram shows the different components of building. Now these are another diagram which shows the building parts. You can guess which parts you are observing in these diagrams. So you are observing the foundation, staircase, columns, floors, etc. you are observing in this diagram. Now main part is the foundation. So foundation is a basic part of structure. So foundation, the structure which are constructed. Foundation, it is the part of substructure which receive the load of superstructure and transmit it to lower and firm strata safely without causing excessive settlement or trusses or any damage to the superstructure. Foundation is a part of structure below the earth surface which consists of the different types of footing such as circular footing, column footing, slope footing, trapezoidal footing, combined footing, etc. Now main purpose of foundation, it uses the stability to of structure and prevent the sliding as well as overturning. It should carry the load safely and transfer to the soil firm strata. Settlement of foundation should be a uniform and within a permissible limit. Due to loads imposed on foundation, structure is like to be settled. Foundation is designed in such a way that settlement is uniform and not differential settlement. Now, uniform settlement means the structure of building is settled down as it is. Just like example is ship. If ship is floating in a water, if load is applied at the center, the ship is sink in a water. If load is applied to the one side of the ship will be tilted. That is a differential settlement. So foundation is very important because whole structure load, that is a load of superstructure, is directly transferred to the foundation, and foundation are taking the load of superstructure. So foundation is very important. Now second part is the plinth. So plinth is a part of the superstructure between the top of the tie beam and at finished ground level. It means it is the above the ground level which consists of in superstructure also. Floors, the floor are the horizontal elements which divide the building into different level for the purpose of creating more accommodation for the occupants, furniture and equipment of a buildings. Masonry wall. So masonry structure is a durable structure or main important part of the building. Masonry work is consist of the two basic part. One is a brick masonry work and stone masonry work. Brick masonries, which consist of the different types of brick, first class brick, second class brick, third class brick, and Zama bricks. Windows. Windows are very essential for opening purpose. Windows are providing or admitting the fresh light, ventilations, air. So windows are provided each and every room to admit the fresh light. Lintel level. Lintel level is one of the building part. So building is a horizontal structure member provided over the doors, windows or other opening to support the superimposed load carried by the wall above the opening. So top level of a door is called as lintel level, or it is also called as a lintel beam. Fill level, the level below the window or bottom level of window is called as a sill level or called as a sill slab. Door is essential to admit the fresh light for assessing point of view. To assess the bedroom, assess the kitchen, you require the doors. Column is a vertical parts of a building which can transfer the load of superstructure to the foundation by the column. So column is a vertical members. Staircase is essential to receive first floor or to assess the first floor, second floor. Staircase is essential. So staircase is basically having the different types: dogleg staircase, helical staircase. In common, dogleg staircase are used on a large scale. Roof, basically roof is a top portion of a building, and in case of a roof is provided on the top of building to view, to keep out the rain, snow, sun, wind, etc. So protection point of view, roof is very important. So roof is having the two types. One is called as a pitch roof and the flat roof. In case of North India, Himalaya area, pitch roof is provided. In case of Shimla, the pitch roof is provided. So aesthetic point of view, pitch roof is also good. But in case of a flat roof, you can use that flat roof. So there is a different purposes of pitch roof and flat roofs. Now last point is a quiz. So after completion of this small lecture, I had given some question: what you learn from the lectures, what is the component of building, definition of foundation, what is a substructure, superstructure, what is the purpose of foundation, what is mean by the sill level and lintel level. All the tests are given on the basis of Bloom taxonomy, which consists of the different points. Remember means recognize and recall the fact. Whatever I taught, you have to recall and remember. Second is you have to understand the meaning of each and every concept. Then you have the ability, you have to apply the facts, you have to apply the rule, you have to apply own ideas, and then after you have to give the knowledge or you have to give answer the questions. Then analyze, break down the information into the component part, you have to analyze. Then evaluate, judging the value of information, ideas, you have to write in proper way. And lastly is important is in a creative manner, you have to give the answers. Okay, this is from my side. Now the last word or last sentence wrote by the Mahatma Gandhi: be the change you want to see in the world. So you have to ability to change the world, be continue, do the hard working, definitely it will help to your career. Thank you so much.